Hello and welcome back to my channel. My name is Neha and today I am going to do a full face of L'Oreal makeup. So if you want to see how I created this look, then please keep on watching. For primer, I am using this L'Oreal Magique Smoothening Primer. This is really good for the people who have textured skin or maybe open pores. I have used this previously and I instantly fell in love with this primer. This is L'Oreal 24-Hour Infallible Foundation. This is supposed to be a waterproof, transferproof and sweatproof foundation. This gives you a nice coverage. Foundation and this does have a really nice coverage and it lasts for a really long time. The only point is that this foundation oxidizes a bit, so please select one shade lighter and try it out on your skin and leave it for a few minutes to see how much it oxidizes and which color would match you better. I like the 24-hour fresh wear foundation more than the infallible 24-hour matte coverage foundation. This also gives you a nice matte coverage, but it won't feel cakey on your skin, whereas this kind of feel a bit cakey on my skin. Moving on to the concealer, infallible full wear concealer has been my favorite since a really long time. You just need a tiniest amount of this concealer. Eyebrows directly, and for my eyebrows I have this L'Oreal Brow Artist Kit. This is a really nice shade match for my skin tone. I'm using the spoolie brush, going to use the gel size and first going to just spoolie my brows. This palette is really nice for everyday use as well and this gives you a quick fuller brows look. Brow kit also has a nice mirror on this side, which is really nice, so you can have a quick look on the go as well. Now I'm going to fill in my brows using this powder. And now using the concealer and a flat brush, I am going to carve out my brows. To set my base, I'm using this L'Oreal Pro Matte Setting Powder. This powder is supposed to give you a nice matte finish for like 16 hours. If you have extremely oily skin like mine, you will have to touch up. It won't last for 16 hours though. But yeah, it gives you a nice matte look. Now I really tried to look up for a bronzer from L'Oreal. Apparently there was only one shade which is very light for me and any other shade was not available on any other site, so I didn't get that. So I'm using this Wet n Wild contour palette to contour my face. For blush, I have this amazing palette from L'Oreal and this shade is called Be Fierce. It also has a nice mirror and it comes with a really tiny brush which is very cute. This blush is super pigmented and I really love the quality. You just need the tiniest amount at once. Moving on to the eyeshadow palette, I'm using this shimmer shade all over my eyelid. I absolutely love this color. This is looking really pretty and very natural, just giving some life back to my eyelid. I'm using this shade in the inner corner. I'm also using a little bit of the same shade on my brow bone. Now I'm going to use the L'Oreal Superline Gel Liner. This is my first time using this gel liner. It has the standard gel liner pot packaging and it comes with a nice brush to apply. The gel liner is gliding super smooth on my eyelids and I'm absolutely enjoying applying this. Absolutely love the gel liner and I'm going back with this green eyeshadow and using an angled brush I'm going to place this on top of the gel liner and kind of setting my gel liner with this green color. And that's how you get a green eyeliner without buying a green eyeliner. And this eyeliner is going to stay put till you remove it. So this is a nice trick if you have the eyeshadow color and you want to turn it into a nice eyeliner. You can also do this by spraying some setting spray on top of your angled brush and then use the brush with your eyeshadow. But I feel that the black gel liner gives a nice intensity to the color. Moving on to the mascara, this is L'Oreal Voluminous Lash Paradise Mascara. This mascara adds a lot of volume to my eyelashes and it properly holds the curl of my eyelash throughout the day. The only issue is removing this mascara. Even if you use an oil-based makeup remover, it is a task to remove this. Moving on to the highlighter. I really like the packaging. This also has a nice mirror and also has a tiny brush to use, but I'm using this brush. The shimmer particles in the highlighter is not finely milled, so it is exaggerating the texture on my skin. For lips, I have two shades from L'Oreal Paris Rouge Signature. I really like the tip of the applicator. This will give you a nice precise application and you can definitely increase the intensity by applying but this is just a single coat and this lipstick stays for a really long time. Even if you have a very heavy meal, they are going to stain your lips, so you will still have the color on your lips. And to set my makeup in place, I'm using this L'Oreal makeup extender. This setting spray will nicely melt all the makeup together. And that's it for today's video for full face of L'Oreal makeup. I enjoy using all of these products. I don't have any product that I didn't like from today's video. I only feel that the highlighter exaggerates a tiny bit of texture on my skin. Apart from that, all the products are really awesome. If you like this video, then do subscribe to my channel. Hit the notification bell so that you are notified every time I post. Do follow me on Instagram @beautifullyneha and I'll see you.